Okay, this is basically the quick version to rough score your buck. I mean, wherever you're at, there's going to be Boone and Crockett scores, Pope and Young scores. Maybe you've got an in-state record book. There'll be someone qualified to officially score your buck. To have them scored and entered into any record book, they've got to have a 60-day drying period, okay? So we're just doing a rough green score right here on the shop bench. I'll show you the quick version of that and kind of some of the points about how you come up with the lines to start with, because there are ways to do it. An official score can show you better than me. But anyways, we're going to come up with some ideas here on how to do it and get it just as close as you can to being right. Okay, we've measured his inside spread and he was 16 exactly. Now, I go with the main beams after that. A lot of people, and even I used to, measure from the very back of the main beam and take the widest point all the way around. But actually, you come down to the side of the bottom of the pedicle, and then you can start and go around the most outside end of the main beam. All right, that's 24. And then I like to take the mass measurements. Each antler gets 4 mass measurements. It don't matter if he's a 6x6 or a 4-point or a 3-point. Each antler gets 4 mass measurements. And you take the smallest diameter around each mass measurement. Now, this tape that I've got is made for these diameters. You can see I've got a little extra here where I can pull it tight. And as you can see there, his right antler's base is 4 4/8. Okay, so what I like to do now is that tells you how much frame he's got, okay? You've got your main beams, you've got your width and your mass. A lot of people say, man, I bet his frame's 100 inches, which that's a pretty good frame on a mature buck. When you get into the next level of buck, you get into a 105 or even maybe 110-inch frame, which is enormous, and that's typically a deer that has extremely good mass. But anyways, you have your frame, and now basically you just add all the tines to it. Okay, here's your tine length, and this is kind of tricky on where you start from. What an official score will typically do, he wants to know where the main beam would have kept going straight across. So then he takes a pencil and he'll put the pencil basically right here. He'll make a little mark, and that's where he will start his measurement, right where it went across if the tine was not there and the beam was to continue, okay? So then we'll turn around and we'll put our mark right there in the center of the tine, and we're going to take the longest way around that tine. That one's 11 1/8. Now most hunters, they don't necessarily care what a deer nets. They want to know what he grosses, what he grew on his head. This is actually an abnormal point that if we were going to net this buck and see what he officially scores, this would be a deduction. Because this is mainly a typical deer, and whenever you have a few of these abnormal points, you've got to deduct those from your official net score. We don't care about that because we're going to add this and we're going to take the total total inches he grew. Doesn't matter if they're non-typical or if they're typical. Even the abnormal points, you got to make sure that you start where it comes off of the tine. Official score will draw a line and then go to that line and measure from the center around the most outside end. That point right there is 4 1/8. So this buck went 167 and 1/8. And again, that's his rough score. Whenever you want to tell your buddies what your buck scored, that's the number you use. Now, if you were going to officially have him scored, of course, they'll come up with a gross score, but they're going to net him. And what that means is these side-to-side differences. So let's say we use the main beams. This main beam was 2 1/2 inches longer. That comes off of this number. Whenever you have an abnormal point and we're scoring him as a typical, that comes off of this number. So whenever you get down to it, this buck was probably going to net in the high 150s. But his gross score is 167 1/8. And probably 99% of the hunters out there use this number.